Let's work through a problem where we have to use the definition of the definite integral. So the directions here are to find the value of the definite integral of x squared plus 2 from 0 to 3 by using the definition of the definite integral with right Riemann sums. Okay, so I've written below here the definition of the definite integral, which is this part of things. Okay, so the definite integral is here, this integral sign of f of x dx from a to b. And what the definite integral represents is the net area bounded by the curve f of x on the interval from a to b. And so the way that's defined is the limit of a general Riemann sum. Okay, so a general Riemann sum is like the Riemann sums we've looked at in the past, except the partition is not necessarily even. Each rectangle could be of a different width. So if you have that general Riemann sum and you take the limit as delta goes to 0, that's the limit as all your rectangle widths go to 0, then that's going to give you the exact net area under the curve. Okay, so that's how the definite integral is defined. Okay, now that would be true, so that should be true for any way that you subdivide your Riemann sum. Okay, so in practice then what we do is when we're actually calculating these, we use an easy way of subdividing the interval. So we use an evenly spaced partition. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to use the Riemann sums we've looked at in the past. And specifically here, we're going to use a right Riemann sum, okay, so that's the formula I've written here, with an even partition, delta x equals b minus a over n. And we're going to take the limit as n goes to infinity, and once again, that's going to give us that exact area under the curve. Okay, so let's start and see how this works out. All right, so what we're saying then is we are interested in this definite integral. Okay, and we're saying we're going to do this by using a right Riemann sum and take the limit as n goes to infinity. Okay, so my formula for a right Riemann sum then is this f of a plus k delta x times delta x. Okay, so let's figure out what our different pieces are. So I'm looking at the interval from 0 to 3. Okay, so a then is going to be 3. And then delta x, I'm using an evenly spaced partition, right, for ease of calculation. So then delta x is just going to be b minus a over n, which is 3 minus 0 over n, so 3 over n. Now, I'm going to keep these n's in my calculation, right? So I'm going to leave everything in terms of n, because in the end, I'm going to take the limit as n goes to infinity. All right, so then if I plug all this into my formula, I have this, the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum from k equals 1 to n of f of, actually, a should be 0. Sorry about that, right? Because our interval is from 0 to 3. So a should be 0. So 0 plus k delta x, so that's 3k over n, times delta x, which is 3 over n. Okay, so now I need to work on actually computing this. So this 3 over n here, that's a constant with respect to the sum, right, because I'm summing over k. So I can go ahead and pull that outside the summation. So 3 over n sum of f of 3k over n. So what this notation means, f of 3k over n, it means take that expression 3k over n and plug it into my function. So remember my function was x squared plus 2. Okay, so if I actually do that step, it's going to look like this. 3 over n sum of, okay, so I'm plugging 3k over n in for x. So 3k over n squared plus 2. Okay, so now we want to go ahead and expand everything out. Okay, so I still have my limit, I still have my sum. Inside the summation, this is going to be 9k squared over n squared plus 2. Okay, so usually it's helpful when computing these sums to break them down. All right, so I'm going to leave this 3 over n out front of everything, but then I'm going to break this sum into two pieces. So the first piece is going to be this 9k squared over n squared. And within that piece, I can actually pull the 9 over n squared out front, because once again, that's a constant with respect to the sum, which is over k. Okay, so I get this 9 over n squared sum of k squared, and then plus the sum of 2. Now, both of these sums are things that I can use my special summation formulas on. So that's what I'm going to do next. So I still have my limit. I have this 3 over n. Then I'm going to have 9 over n squared times the sum of k squared from k equals 1 to n. So if you recall, that formula is n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. And then plus, I have the sum of 2, so the sum of a constant is that constant times n, so plus 2n. Okay, so we've gotten rid of the sums. Now, ultimately, I'm going to want to take the limit of this. To do that, it's going to be really helpful if I clean things up a little bit. So notice here that I have it in this first fraction inside the brackets. I have an n in the top and an n squared in the bottom, so I can do a little simplification there, and a 9 up here and a 6 down here. Okay, so that's going to become, still have this 3 over n out front, and then this first fraction is going to be 3n plus 1, 2n plus 1 over 2n, and then I have this plus 2n. Alright, and I'm going to go ahead now and distribute the 3 over n to the terms inside the brackets. So if I do that, that's going to become 9 n plus 1, 2 n plus 1 over 2 n squared plus 6. Okay, now this is a lot nicer, right? So let's take a look at the terms here and think about how we might take these limits. So the 6 is no problem, right? The plus 6, that's going to be easy to take the limit of. But this fraction, maybe a little trickier. So if you think about plugging in infinity there, I'm going to end up getting the form infinity over infinity. So there's a few different ways I could approach that. Probably the easiest way would actually be to use L'Hôpital's rule. So I think that's what I'm going to do. And to do that, it's going to be easier if I FOIL out that top. So that's what I'm going to do next. Okay, so this is going to be 9 times a quantity, 2n squared plus, okay, I have an n and a 2n, so plus 3n plus 1 over 2n squared. And then I'm going to split up this limit because I can't use L'Hôpital's rule on 6. Okay, so then this first limit is the limit as n goes to infinity of 18n squared plus 27n plus 9 over 2n squared. And then I'll have my limit of 6, which I'll deal with later. Okay, so now we see a little more the form of this function, right? So it definitely is infinity over infinity. And So the two ways you could do this are you could divide every term by n squared and then take the limit, or use L'Hôpital's rule. So I'm going to use L'Hôpital's rule. So remember, L'Hôpital's rule says that if you have a 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity limit, you can take, it's equivalent to the limit if you take the derivative of the top and bottom. So in my case, it's going to equal the limit of 36n plus 27 over 4n, okay, and I still have my limit of 6 hanging out here. Well, it's still an infinity over infinity limit, so I can use L'Hôpital's rule again, and I get the limit as n goes to infinity of 36 over 4. Okay, well now everything's constants. So this just equals 36 over 4, which is 9. 9 plus 6, which equals 15. So 15 is the answer to the definite integral. So the definite integral from 0 to 3 of x squared plus 2 dx equals 15.